Welcome to clickmyproject.com.
Now we are going to discuss about the product Core Saliency Detection for RGBD images based on multi-constraint feature matching and cross-label population. Now we are going to discuss about the abstract for the process. In this process, we process a Core Saliency Detection model for RGBD images. The flowchart of the proposed model. Firstly, the basic intra-saliency map is generated by single saliency detection method associating with the depth flow on the individual images. Then, two similarity matching methods on different scales are designed to acquire the corresponding relationship among the multiple images. Combining the corresponding relationship and the intra-saliency map, then the intersaliency map of each image is generated. In order to further improve the consistency of saliency objects and suppress the background regions, a CRP optimization scheme is designed to refine the intra- and intersaliency map in the crossway. At last, the weighted averaging fusion is used to produce the final core saliency result. Now we are going to discuss about the flow diagram for the process. This is the overall flow structure for the process. At first, the input image is taken from the dataset. The dataset is the folder which consists of the several images. Like this, we have several images in the dataset. Select any one image from the dataset. After selecting the image from the dataset, the pre-processing is carried out. In this pre-processing step, we are using the image resize. So, in the image resize, we can reduce the dimension by the aspect ratios. After the resize, the saliency detection is carried out. In this saliency detection, we have to segregate the step into two steps. First one is the intra-saliency map, then the second one is the inter-saliency map. The inter-saliency and the intra-saliency are somewhat similar to each other. After getting the inter-saliency and the intra-saliency result, the optimization and propagation is carried out. In this optimization and propagation step, we have using the fusion result. And also we have extracted some features from the inter and intra saliency map. By using those features, we optimize the features as a corresponding limit. Then the core saliency map is generated. That is the core saliency direction. In this core saliency direction, the required object, that is the region of interest, is extracted and the other backgrounds will be suppressed. After the segmentation, the performance is estimated. In this performance estimation, we are using the parameters like precision, recall, F-measure and error. By using these four parameters, we can justify our process is efficient or not. Now we are going to discuss about the initial running procedure for the process. At first, open the MATLAB 2015 and change the current directory. If you want to execute the code, means just right click in the main _gui.m file and select the option run. Now the initial GUI design was opened. In that you can see the several axes for the display purpose and the tabulation for the display purpose, and in the top of that you can see the menu bar. In the menu bar, select the file and import image. Now open the dataset and then select any one image from the dataset. After selecting the image from the dataset, the corresponding image is shown in the axis 1 with the title input image. After receiving the input image from the dataset, the pre-processing is carried out. In this pre-processing step, we applying the image resize. After the resizing, the resized image is shown in the axis 2 with the title resized image. Now you can see the difference between the input image and then the size of the resized image. Now click the button saliency detection. In this saliency detection, we have the two options. First one is the intra-selection saliency detection and then the second one is the inter-saliency detection. First, click the intra-saliency detection. After clicking the button intra-saliency detection, it will take some time to process, and after the process completed means those images shown in the axis. Now the intra-saliency result is shown in the axis 2 with the title intra-saliency image. Now in the intra-saliency image, the background will be somewhat suppressed, and then the foreground region is extracted like this. After the finishing the process intra-saliency detection, the inter-saliency detection will be carried out. In this inter-saliency detection, the image is slightly converted to the binary format. Hence, the white regions represents the ones and the black regions represent the zeros. Now, the optimization and propagation is carried out. In this optimization and propagation, the lamp conversion and then the RGB conversion map is shown in the axis 3 and then the axis 4. Those results are shown here. After that, the final core saliency map is detected. Hence, the core saliency map results are shown in the axis 4, axis 5 and then the axis 6. Hence, these are the results for the core saliency detection. After detecting the core saliency region, then the segmentation performance is estimated by using the parameters like accuracy, sensitivity, specificity, precision, recall, error measure and error rate. Now the accuracy of the overall process is 87.6%, sensitivity is 86.8%, now the specificity is 97.0%, precision is 99.6, recall is 86.8, error measure is 92.8, then the error is 0.3. Now those values are plotted in the bar chart format that is shown in the figure 10.
Thanks for watching this video.